right out the gate, let's get a baseline of what I think is the subject thinks. He's telling the truth. It's somewhat of the truth, as close as the truth as he can manage. Look at the hands. This is a baseline that we think he's telling the truth in his mind, right here. Now, this person is so good at deception that we're going to have to just focus on his hands mostly, but very rarely you can see it in his eyes. See his eyes? His eyes show you when he thinks he's doing a good job of fooling you. Watch the eyes right here. Right here. You see that? He thinks he's doing a very good job of fooling you when you see those eyes do that. There they go. They're closed, and he says, I gotcha. All right. So again, I ran across a person who is such a storyteller on another level. I don't think I've ever seen such a compulsive liar or exaggerator on this scale. He is so good, so good, but he's so easy to spot. Looking for tells, I think it's in his hands. So as I talk, focus on his hands. I think his hands give him away. Matter of fact, I know his hands give him away. But what a genius of a manipulator he is. And he uses his hands as a tool. I mean, he thinks he's fooling you. Now, he realizes that his tattoos are his biggest mistake in life, and he is actively trying to remove them. I wish him good luck on this. So you will want to focus when he squeezes his hands there in his pinkies. As the video goes on, you'll want to focus on his pinkies. His studio made-up acting name is Mickey Mays. Mickey Mays. His latest con is to convince the world that he is the king of Baccarat. I repeat, the king of Baccarat, where he's won millions in Las Vegas and they have banned him. And apparently his con has gone off without a hitch. He's doing very, very well on social media. You know, he's fooling lots of people. But if you are in law enforcement, this kid would be perfect to study and learn the ticks and the movements of deception. Did you notice that? Did you notice his pinky? Watch his pinky right here. See the pinky? That's what you focus on. Now, it's clear from his upbringing, he's had lots of problems early on. It's clear from his upbringing that he can read people with amazing skills. He can see through people in super quick speed. This is how he can con people so easily. This comes from being thrown into so many different places at a young age with so many different types of people, and that part of his brain that reads people is super, super strong. The best actors in Hollywood, the best actors in Hollywood have this early lifestyle going from school to school. He actually had to drop out of school. He was put in different types of, you know, delinquency places, moving here and there, meeting so many different people and so many different types of people. And like actors, you know, actors get paid to lie, and he trusts nobody. He trusts nobody, and this is to be expected, and this is actually a positive in his life. You should not trust anybody. But watch his hands. I mean, he uses his hands as a tool when he's trying to fool people. And he's only about 32, 33, which we think is young, but he started his life of deception and getting in trouble at such a young, young age that now he is in his prime years of fooling people. But see the pinky? Look at the pinky. He has his tells. And during this interview, he also said that rap stars are his heroes. That's a big red flag. I mean, if you look up the rap stars, that's a big problem. He has an Instagram link. This is a big, big red flag. His biggest fear is not being liked. Wow, get help, but that's to be expected, I guess. Vaping is a big red flag. That's not good. He's a very troubled person, and he admits this. He's a very smart and clever person. Even though he dropped out of school at an early age, he's very, very intelligent, but very, very troubled. And he still needs his dad's approval. After every bad thing he's ever done in his life, he still needs his dad's approval. This is so textbook. Textbook right there. Why he has Salvador Dali on his neck, I have to work on that one. I don't understand the Salvador Dali on his neck. but I don't think I've ever seen a compulsive liar on this scale.
From that kind of lifestyle, I saw every type of con and cheat and steal that exists, you know, in every nook and cranny of every type of street. And
he's telling the truth here. He's seen so many different cons, so many different angles, and he wants to take it to another level, the Vegas level.
My biggest fear is not being liked, not being wanted or accepted, and
I think he's telling the truth here, and that's very, very sad indeed. And, of course, vaping is not good either.